Hey, today I'm going to go through how you can add a NAS device into NovaBackup as a destination device or network share, NAS, share on another machine, whatever you want to call it. In this case, I already have NovaBackup installed, and I'm already at the location where I want to store that data. So in this case, it's a network share on another Windows machine, but it could be a NAS, same difference. I'm going to go to the Device tab in the software. Click on Add. Then I'm actually going to choose Local Backup. Local Backup is going to give you the choice of both backing up to a local device or, in this case, a network share. I'll click OK. Device name, I'm just going to call it Demo Storage. I'll just call it Demo NAS. How about that? And then I'm going to put that same folder that I already have from Windows Explorer in here. And then network credentials, this is going to be how the software actually communicates with that storage. You're always going to need to put some sort of network credentials in there when you're going to a NAS or a network share. In this case, it's going to be administrator and then password. I'll click OK. It's going to take a couple seconds here, and then it will add that device. So that device is in there called Demo NAS. I can go to the backup tab and I'll just call create a new backup called NAS backup. And I'm going to go to C drive. I'm just going to choose the users directory and then choose where I want to back it up to. This NAS device. I'll go to settings. Settings are going to be like for notifications, how you want the thing to run as, and that type of thing. But the most important portion is the device retention. This device retention tells the software how long to keep versions of files out there. So you'll do a full backup, or it'll back up everything the initial time, and then from that point forward, it's going to just do new and changed files that are in that backup selection to that device. So in this case, I'll keep it. The default's going to be 30 days, and I'll keep it at that default. So it's going to keep, your initial backup, and then 30 days worth of versions of files or new files. So it's always going to have at least the last version of every file that is protected here. So I'll click OK there. Click Save. It's going to ask you where you what you want to save it as. Just save it as that, and I can click Backup. You'll see it actually create the folder out on that network share. That really is all there is to setting up a backup job to go to a network share or a NAS.